My name is Orhan Akmadov. I'm the HSC and offshore survival instructor in the internationally recognized company named Hill Island. If you will go to BP, to Schlumberger, to Halliburton, you have to pass specific and important training. Name of this training is Dossier. Have you ever heard about it? Not so many people heard about it. Yeah. Okay. First of all, let me start about one important thing for you. I always don't like, I hate, by the way, when the people with the big technical background, big technical knowledge, are starting to speak with the young people, unexperienced people, in very, very detailed technical way. What's the conclusion? Young people, students, are not able to understand it. Okay? You are just wasting your time just sitting and just listening. Maybe sometimes not listening. That's why. This is not the part of training and development. If you want to train, if you want to develop, I should be as simple as I can. Everything should be explained, all technical learnings, all formulas and so on. So, as I said, you have to pass the main training named Bossier. Here you can find the name Bossier. Bossier is the main training in the offshore oil and gas industry. Each offshore staff should pass this training. What is the Bossier stands for? You can see. Basic Offshore Safety Induction and Emergency Training. You will be equipped with the basic knowledge about offshore, and you will be equipped with the basic knowledge about emergency actions, emergency reactions. And what we will talk about actually here, this is what is offshore, basics of offshore oil and gas industry. Then what is emergency, what to do during the emergency, and how the big companies are handling the emergency. Strong wind, rain, and you are the platform and work, light ship. Imagine. It's not so easy. That's why offshore is not for them. Proximity of working and living environment already discussed here. So, why offshore is important? Offshore, the platforms, any installation offshore, construction process of the platform demands a high knowledge and high experience from the designers. Because imagine onshore wind. In case of emergency, the worst case scenario, what you will do? Just run the inlet. But are you able to do that offshore? Why you want your friend to be safe? And why your friend wants you to be safe? Because of your humanity. That's moral. He's my friend. I know that anything with this guy, any harm to this guy, will lead to stress of his family, of his kids, his wife, mother, father, your mother. That's why this is a moral way of keeping our workplace, our environment safe. Second one, if I am the bad person, I don't want anybody to be safe. What will stop me to do something bad? Laws, regulation. If you will do it, you will be fine. 100 mana, I don't know, 500 mana. The same as the road safety. Yeah? If you will do something, you will be fine. The same here. The different countries, different companies are setting the regulations, which will stop you to do something wrong. And the last thing. We are always giving the financial way. Any injury, any emergency leads to what? Damage to asset, damage to building, injured people. Yeah? And this is awesome. During the emergency, if something happened, what kind of financial, what kind of costs we will have? We will have direct costs. Let me write it down. First of all, What's the difference? So, direct cost. You are the VP, for example. You are founder. Something happened with your employee. You know that you will pay for his hospitalization. You will pay for insurance, or insurance will pay for him. Okay? These are costs. These are direct costs. You know about them. But what are the indirect costs? You don't know how it will harm, how it will impact your company reputation. You know that? Maybe it will impact very, very hard your company reputation. Maybe everybody will hate your company, but maybe you don't. You don't know. Indirect costs also. Person was injured. Hospitalization happened, okay. But unfortunately, Allah göstermez, person died in the hospital. It was not predictable.
Self-propelled platform. For moving this platform from one position to another, we need special vessel. Topo, Uxiv.
That's not the Uxiv either.
Semi-submersible platform. You see,
we have this kind of platforms. They are popular in Azerbaijan. Haider Ali, very first one.
We will use star shape construction. You see? This is the iceberg. In order not to have the Titanic begin. Ice will come, iceberg will come, will hit. This is iceberg, will hit there's no problem. If you don't have this kind of risk, okay, ordinary construction. Any questions up to you? We have everything related to floating structure, to production, to storage, and so forth. This system actually swings between the platform, sails between the platform, takes the whole crude oil, produces this oil, and the tanker from the different country is coming, attaching to this FPSO, taking all of this oil and going back. Why we don't have the FPSO in the Caspian region of Azerbaijan? We don't have it. Why? It's good, by the way, yeah? To have everything offshore, nothing, no terminal, no nothing in terminal, but we don't have it. Because of distance. Our platforms are not so far from shore. If you will compare them with the ocean, with the Gulf of Mexico, with North Sea, they are not so far. That's why we have four pipelines. We have terminal. And we are selling our oil mostly by using pipelines. PTC cutting industry. But we have countries who are selling their oil by using tankers. Vietnam, main tanker, China tanker. This is able to carry 22,000 tons of chlorine. Imagine it from Kuzdaşı. What does it mean? That means this is less reliable on supply. One thing, you always are spending the money to send the pipes, to send the cables in every week. But here, it took 22,000 tons and just worked for 6 months. Another record, deepest pipeline. It's able to lay the pipes at the depths of 3,000 meters of the water. Limited time, unusual situation, injured personnel, damage to asset, and communication problems. Always and always we have a combination of these factors.
You touch one.
Grab that. Just take it immediately and go. We have this bag per person. For example, cabin for two guys, yeah, we will have two bags. What we have in this bag? We have smoke hood. Hood which will protect yourself from the smoke. Then we have gloves. Fire retardant gloves. Gloves which are not able to take fire. And then torch. Torch. Purpose? Smoky environment, darkness, donate with torch and with gloves, find your way out from your cabin through corridor and